Now we'll be discussing about matrices. Now a matrix is just a rectangular array of numbers or elements which is expressed in rows or columns and enclosed in brackets. So basically it is just some numbers or some elements which are arranged in rows and columns and enclosed in square bracket. It's same as determinant. We have already discussed about determinants. So determinant are the elements or numbers which are enclosed in vertical lines, wherein matrices again numbers or elements which are enclosed in bracket. Okay, now order of the matrix is represented by or given by number of rows into number of columns. Now in this case we have two rows, this is your R1, R2, and we have three columns C1, C2, C3. So order of this matrix will be 2×3, two rows and three columns. For example, let me take another example here. Now suppose we have a matrix. Now in this case we have three rows R1, R2, R3 and three columns C1, C2 and C3. So the order of this matrix will be 3×3. So this represents row, number of rows, and this represents number of columns. Okay. Now next is types of matrices. So the first type we have is a row matrix. Row matrix. Now what is row matrix? In this case, the elements are arranged along the row. If the elements are arranged along the row, then it is called as a row matrix. Okay. So a matrix having all its elements along the row, then it is called as a row matrix. For example, suppose I am taking matrix A. Okay, so the all the elements are arranged along the first row. Even though we have three columns here, but the we have here only one row. All the elements are arranged along the row. That is the reason it is called as a row matrix. Next is column matrix. Column matrix. Again, it's same thing. In this case, all its elements, okay, a matrix in which all the elements are arranged along its column. For example, so here we have only one column. Let me take this as matrix B. So this is called as a column matrix, wherein all the elements are arranged along the one column, here along the one row. So this is called as a row matrix and this is called as a column matrix. Next is null matrix. It is also called as a zero matrix. Now order of this matrix can be anything, but the only thing is all the elements are going to be zero. Okay, so a matrix whose every element is zero. Okay, it is called as a zero matrix. It can be 2×2, so two rows, two columns. It can be 2×3, it can be 3×3, but every element in the matrix has to be zero, then only it is called as a either null matrix or zero matrix. Now fourth type of matrix what we have is a square matrix. What is a square whose length as well as breadth is equal, right? All four sides are equal, then only we can say it is a square. What is a square matrix? If the number of rows as well as number of columns are equal, then we can say it is a square matrix. Okay, so if number of rows is equal to number of columns, then it is called as a square matrix. For example, so here we have two rows and two columns, so it is called as a square matrix. Another example, so here we have three rows and three columns, R1, R2, R3, C1, C2, C3, three rows and three columns, so this is also called as a square matrix. Next we have is a identity matrix. Identity matrix. Now this is also a square matrix. Okay, a square matrix whose diagonal elements are unit. Okay, unit as in one. So let me take one example. Now suppose we are talking about 2 cross 2, this is your diagonal, right? So in diagonal it has to be unit and every other element will be 0. Diagonal elements are unit and every other element is a 0. Then only it is called as a identity matrix. Okay. Let's take 3 cross 3 example. So again, this is your diagonal, this is called as a principal diagonal, the first diagonal. We are not talking about second diagonal, okay? This is called as a principal diagonal, and elements on this diagonal has to be 1, and every other element is going to be 0. Then only we can say it is a identity matrix of order 3 cross 3. This is identity matrix of order 2 cross 2. Now basically, identity matrix is represented by letter I. Okay, so if instead of these alphabets we can even use here letter I. So how many types we have studied? The first one was row matrix, then column matrix, null or zero matrix, then we have square matrix, and then identity matrix. So we have studied total 5 types of matrices.